Good morning, everyone, and happy Friday. Welcome back to another sports card video. Today, I'm going to go over the top 10 sleeper baseball cards going into the second half of the Major League Baseball season. We just finished the All-Star game. We had a game postponed yesterday due to COVID. It's very unfortunate. I'm hearing rumors about cases on the rise and a variant, and really don't like to hear that kind of news because we're just getting back into the swing of things where we see fans in the stands and players having fun, teams finally getting on track and getting their whole lineups together. And I really hope we don't have another outbreak of players missing due to COVID protocol, but we'll see how that goes. Anyway, just wanted to get into the top 10 sleepers that I believe are the top 10 sleepers for the second half of the baseball season. And at number 10, we're gonna go with the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim and Jared Walsh. One of the things that I've been preaching for the Angels and the Angels lineup is that they might make the playoffs. Well, I checked Fangraphs today and it doesn't look like they have that great of a chance to make the playoffs. It says here they have a 15.6% chance to make the playoffs. I guess that's not the worst thing in the world. However, I did notice that the Braves only have an 8.8% chance to make the playoffs. I don't think you can count the Braves out just yet, just because of that Acuña injury. We'll get into that later. But I still like the Angels lineup. I like Jared Walsh. He's having a very nice season. 22 home runs, 65 RBIs. He's batting .278. He's been holding down that Angel lineup while Mike Trout, Anthony Rendon, and Justin Upton have been injured. You could pick up his card on StarStock for $4. I think that's a great play for the price point. For $4, why not take a chance on Jared Walsh? He's in a nice lineup. He's got Mike Trout, got Shohei Ohtani in the lineup. There's going to be a lot of eyes on him just for that reason alone. It's really worth the shot at number 10. Number 9, we have Anthony Rendon, also on the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim. I don't like that name. Anthony Rendon has a very nice track record, and this is what I like about a lot of these plays that I'm going to mention today. They have a track record. They're probably not going to be in the minor leagues next year, and that's important. If you're investing in like a Bobby Witt or Wander Franco or even somebody who just here today, gone tomorrow, like a lot of the Dodgers players, those are very risky investments. They might have a hot week and you may never hear from them again. This is what I love about Anthony Rendon. 2 years ago, World Series, Nationals win the World Series. He hit 34 home runs, led the league in RBIs with 126. He hit .319 and finished third in MVP voting. He also finished 11th in MVP voting the year before that and sixth in MVP voting in 2017. He has a nice track record. He's been plagued by injury this year, but once he comes back, and he's expected to come back very soon, if he can get right, if he can get healthy, in the middle of that order with Mike Trout and Shohei Ohtani, I really like the play there. You can pick up his Topps Update PSA 10 for around $30. That to me is dirt cheap. Number 8, we have New York Yankees Gerrit Cole. Now, this is a pitcher, and a lot of people don't like investing in pitchers. I know there's that injury risk. Gerrit Cole's had a nice track record. If you look at 2 years ago, he went 20-5, 2.50 ERA, and led the league in strikeouts with 326, second in Cy Young voting, and 10th in the MVP race. So he even was in the MVP conversation. If anything, if you're going to invest in a pitcher, you want to invest in a strikeout pitcher, and that's what Gerrit Cole is. He's leading the league in strikeouts again with 147, 9-4, 2.68 ERA. You could pick up his StarStock A Topps Update card for between $5 to $10. Dirt cheap, you can get his PSA 10 Topps Update for about $80 to $85. Number 7 on the list, we have Nick Castellanos from the Reds. Now, one of the things I liked about Nick Castellanos is the Reds are making a push. They're trying to catch the Brewers. And I was listening to MLB radio and the announcers were mentioning that the Reds are starting to make some noise and they're starting to nip. You're starting to hear footsteps. The Brewers are starting to hear footsteps. However, I did check Fangraphs to see the percentage of chance that the Reds have of making the playoffs. and it looks like they have a 22% chance. So not the greatest, but I believe that the way things are going to shake out, we just don't know. When I look at Fangraphs and I see that the Giants are 91.5% chance to make the playoffs, I believe there's a very good chance that they don't make the playoffs. If the Dodgers and the Padres get hot and the Giants finish third, they could find themselves out of the playoff race altogether. So I'm not sure why that percentage is so high. If you have any other reason, again, please leave a comment below. Also with the Brewers, they have an 84% chance to make the playoffs. Again, if the Reds stay hot and catch them and other teams pass them up, I mean, there's a lot of close records in the major leagues right now. I don't see why certain teams have such a high percentage and other teams just really seem to have no chance at all. In any case, I like Nick Castellanos. He's hitting .331, leading the league in batting average. He also has 18 home runs, 59 RBIs, and he also has a nice track record. If you look at 2019 or 2018, let me just see here which year. No, it was 2019. He hit 58 doubles 2 years ago. And he also had 27 home runs, 73 RBIs, and he hit .289. It looks like he's hitting for a higher average even now, and I feel like this is really his breakout year. He's 29 years old, probably has a lot more good years ahead of him, and if he ends up on a contender, if he gets traded to the Yankees or the Red Sox or the Angels, I'm just throwing the Angels as a possible playoff team, he could see a spike in value for that reason alone. You could pick up his Topps Chrome PSA 10. There's only 10 of them in existence. It's a pop 10 for $75. Dirt cheap. Number six, JD Martinez. Red Sox lineup. I like the Red Sox lineup in general. He hits third in the Red Sox lineup with 18 home runs, 62 RBIs, batting .299. He's been very solid all year long. He started out hot, kind of cooled off, but he's still putting up some solid numbers. If he hits another hot streak, which he's been known to do, that could cause a spike in his prices, especially if that comes toward the end, toward the playoff run as they make the playoff push. Look at his numbers, though, from 2 years ago. 36 home runs, 105 RBIs. He batted .304, finished 21st in MVP voting. 3 years ago, 43 home runs, 130 RBIs. He batted .330 and finished fourth in MVP voting. He had two really good back-to-back years, 2018, 2019. Last year was the short year, the COVID year. I look at it as a throwaway year. I don't really pay attention to that when I'm looking at consistency. And when you look this year, he's back on track with, again, 18 home runs, 62 RBIs, batting .299. If you prorate that out, he should finish with over 30 home runs, over 100 RBIs, and if he finishes batting over .300, that's going to be another nice, solid season. But what I like about JD Martinez is his ability to get hot. And also, if he gets hot in the playoffs, watch out. You can pick up his PSA 10 Topps Update 2011 for $50. It's criminally undervalued. I think it's a great play. I would buy some JD Martinez. Number five, I like Ozzie Albies. And this is what I was talking about earlier. With the Acuna injury, you would think the Braves are out of it, but I like the Braves team as a whole. They have the last year's MVP in Freddie Freeman. Ozzie Albies is starting to play like the all-star that he is. He started out slow, but he's starting to pick it up. He has 15 home runs, 61 RBIs, batting .262. Again, I like his short track record here. 2 years ago, he led the league in hits, 189 hits. He had 24 home runs, 86 RBIs, batted .295. Was a Silver Slugger Award winner. And 2018, 24 home runs, 72 RBIs. He only hit .261, but you can see that he's been putting up numbers. He's very young. He's only 24 years old. And I think that with Acuna out, I think that's going to motivate the Braves lineup to step it up. And I like the second half of the season for Ozzie Albies. You could pick up his Star Stock A Topps Chrome for $5. Unbelievably cheap for how good these players are. Number four, we'll go back to the Boston Red Sox. Rafael Devers, 22 home runs, 72 RBIs. He's batting .282 in the middle, the heart of that Red Sox order. He's been clutch time in and time out. I like his numbers from 2 years ago as well. 54 doubles, 32 home runs, 115 RBIs. He hit 311 and finished 12th in the MVP voting. Even the year before that, he had a decent season. 21 home runs, 66 RBIs. He didn't bat very well. But it looks like he's figuring things out. 2 years ago, he had a phenomenal season. This year, it looks like it's shaping up for another phenomenal season. Probably not as good of a track record as Anthony Rendon or JD Martinez or some of the more veteran players, but I like the upside. I also like his age. He's only 24 years old, and you can pick up his Topps Chrome PSA 10 rookie card for only $85. All of these plays are under $100. Pop count's not even that high, 2,102. Not excessive, especially for how good he is. Again, big market. Red Sox are in first place in the middle of a very good lineup. I really like Rafael Devers. Number three, we're going to go with my Los Angeles Dodgers, Walker Buehler, another pitcher. I don't shy away from pitchers. I know most people do. They don't like the risk, the risk of arm injury. They don't like Tommy John surgery. They really don't want to play with that risk, similar to a running back in the NFL. However, I like Walker Buehler long term. If Walker Buehler can stay healthy, and I'm just going to assume that's what we're going to work with as far as our knowledge here, that he finishes out the year healthy. He's 9-1 right now with a 2.36 ERA, 114 strikeouts. It's shaping up to be a very nice season. The Dodgers will be in the playoffs. If you look at Fangraphs, they actually have the highest percentage chance to make the playoffs at 99.5%. So we should see the Dodgers in the playoffs, and we'll see Walker Buehler in the playoffs yet again, and he dominated last year. I think he was overshadowed by Clayton Kershaw and the narrative that he chokes in the playoffs. Corey Seager was having incredibly hot in the playoffs and ended up winning the World Series MVP. So we really didn't pay attention to how well Walker Buehler pitched last year in the playoffs, but we'll see him there again this year. And he might get more of a spotlight. You can pick up his Topps Chrome Star Stock A for between $4 and $5. You can actually pick up his Topps Chrome PSA 10 for $55 on Star Stock. To me, that is a steal. This is a nice long-term play. I believe he's going to be a Dodger great for the next decade. He is the next Clayton Kershaw. And he might even be better than Clayton Kershaw because he wins more in the postseason. Number two. We're going to go back to the Red Sox. I'm not a Red Sox fan, but I like the Red Sox lineup, and I like Xander Bogaerts. Xander Bogaerts is 28 years of age, and I like his track record. If you look back, he actually, over the last 3 years, last year he finished 17th in MVP voting, 2019 5th, and 2018 13th. So he's been in the MVP at least talk for the last 3 years. Look at his numbers from 2 years ago, 33 home runs, 117 RBIs. He hit 309. Even in last year's throwaway year, he had 11 home runs, 28 RBIs, and he hit 300. And this year, off to a very nice start, 27 doubles, 15 home runs, 51 RBIs, and he's batting 321. I really feel like Xander Bogaerts is just being slept on in general. I like that he's in the, again, big market in the Red Sox lineup. I like the year that his rookie card is, 2014. It's a low print run year. And you could pick up his Topps rookie, his 2014 Topps rookie in a PSA 10 for $85. That is a nice play. Again, the pop count on that is only 247. Compare that to Rafael Devers Topps Chrome with a pop count of 2,102 for the exact same price. I would much rather have a Xander Bogaerts, again, for the year that his rookie card was, which is a lower print run year, and I look at them as roughly the same. I think either way, you couldn't go wrong with either play, but I like Xander Bogaerts. I like the 2014 year. I like how rare the card is, and you can still get it at a very nice price point, $85. Number one on the list, we're going to go back to New York, Francisco Lindor. Now, Francisco Lindor shouldn't be a sleeper. If you look at these stats, it's unbelievable. He was Rookie of the Year 2015, ninth in MVP voting in 2016, fifth in 2017, sixth in 2018, and 15th in MVP voting 2 years ago. He has put up some unbelievable numbers over those years. And if you look at 2017, 2018, that's when the power really started to come into play. 33 home runs, 89 RBIs. He hit 273. And then in 2018, he had 38 home runs, 92 RBIs, and he hit 277. Those were the years that he finished fifth and sixth in the MVP voting race. 2 years ago, he had another nice season, and he actually hit again, he hit over 30 home runs again, 32 home runs, 74 RBI. So he has shown the power 3 years in a row. We're going to go ahead and look, you know, throw away 2020 because that was just a 60-game season. And this year, he is off to an incredibly slow start. And that has really brought down the prices of his cards, which is why I've included him on this list. There are other players that have had similar circumstances. Mookie Betts is one of them. Corey Seager is another one of them. Actually, Cody Bellinger is another one too. And I know about all three of them because they're on my Dodgers. However, though their prices are still pretty high, and I don't think people are really truly sleeping on them, you know, yet. I think that if Corey Seager and Cody Bellinger continue to either stay hurt or not get hot, then their prices might continue to fall, and I may have put them on the list. But Lindor has been cold since the start. But I like that he's on the Mets. They're in first place. It's in a big market. It's the media capital of the world. He signed the big long-term contract. He's not going anywhere. You can pick up his tops. His Topps Chrome PSA 10 for $335, but you can actually pick up his Topps Update PSA 10 for about $150. To me, that is way too cheap for somebody who is, again, in the heart of the Mets order, the first place Mets. I don't think we've seen everything that they have to offer yet. I think that that lineup has yet to heat up, yet they're still in first place. So I'm pretty excited for the second half of the season. I'm excited to see what Francisco Lindor can do. Please let me know what you think in the comments of this top 10. Was it helpful? Do you have different players that you would have put in the top 10? Like the video if you like it. Please subscribe if you like the videos that are coming out. And I'm happy to do a video on any topic. My sports are baseball, basketball, and football. I've been mainly doing baseball lately because we're in the middle of baseball season. Basketball is basically at an end and football hasn't started. I'm not really big on speculating how football is going to play out, but I probably will do some of those videos as well. I hope you enjoyed this video, and please like, and I will see you on the next one.